Welcome back everyone, my name is Abdullah Ghori from Alpha Technology, and in this video we'll talk about nested if else statements. So in previous video we have created a simple calculator using if else statements. If you missed that video, you can check it out. I have dropped the link in the description section. And if you're not already the subscriber of Alpha Technology, I recommend you to subscribe our channel and hit the bell icon so you don't miss any new video. So without any further delay, let's start our video. So first of all, what is nested if statements? A nested if statement is a statement which is inside another if statements. Whenever we type a if statement inside another if statement, it is called nested if statements. So where we actually use the nested if statements? So let's say we have to create a program in which we are storing two numbers, first number and second number, in two variables. And we have two conditions to follow. Number one is we have to check if the first number is greater than the second number. If yes, then we have to check another thing, that is the number is odd or even. Else we'll say the first number is not greater than the second number. Okay, so in first case we are checking two conditions. So this thing we can only achieve with nested if statements. So let's create our program. We'll say int first number and comma second number, and we'll print a message to user that enter first number, and we'll store this first number in the first number variable. And we'll print another message to user, enter second number, and we'll store the second number in the second num variable. And here we'll check our condition. The first condition is there if the first number is greater than the second number. So we'll say if first number is greater than the second number. So now here we are checking if first number is greater than second number. If yes, we'll say cout first number is greater than second number. And we'll check another condition. We have to check another condition, is the number, is the first number is odd or even. So we'll say if, and in the inner parenthesis we'll say first number mod 2. That's mean whenever we divide any number with 2, it returns 0 or 1. So if it's returned 0, that means it is an even number, else it is an odd number. I have a separate video on even and odd numbers, you can watch it. I drop the link in the description section below. So here we are saying that divide the first number with 2. So if the remainder equal to 0, we can say that this is an even number. We'll say even number. And else we'll say odd number. Now here we are checking the first condition. If the first number is greater than second number, we are printing that first number is greater than second number. And also we are checking an other condition, that is the number is even or odd. So this condition, this if else statement, is known as nested if else statement. This statement is inside this statements, so we can say that this is a nested if else statement. So here we can say else, if the number is, if the first number is not greater than the second number, that means we'll say first number is not greater than the second number. Okay, so now let me build and run this program. So it is asking for enter first number. We'll say our first number is 13, and it is saying that enter second number, will enter 5 there. And in this case it must say that first number is greater than second number and even number. So enter. So it says first number is greater than second number, and it says odd number. Sorry, this is an odd number. So it says first number is greater than second number, and it is an odd number. Obviously 13 is odd number. So let's check for even number. So we'll say 12, 2, and now it is saying that first number is greater than second number and it is an even number. And if we enter small number first and then a bigger number or greater number, so it will say first number is not greater than the second number and the second thing will not be shown to us. So that's how we use nested if else statement in C++ programming and other programming language as well. So if you like my video, hit the like button and subscribe our channel and hit the bell icon so you don't miss any new video. If you have any question, you can comment below. I will answer your all the question. I have uploaded so many videos on C++ and also I will uploading more and more videos so you can learn many things from Alpha Technology. Thank you.